Hi everyone, welcome to Carson City Library's Computers for Beginners video tutorial on the internet. My name is Vanna Bells and I am the Creative Learning Librarian where we offer programs for all ages. I've adapted the in-person lesson for this video and I've added a list of resources at the end to enhance your learning. I appreciate and welcome all feedback, so please fill out the survey in the description. Questions? Email me at creativelearning@carsoncitylibrary.org. Today, we're going to learn about terminology, how to navigate internet browsers, and find your settings. Let's get started. The internet is, in short, a global network. How do you access the internet? You have to pay for or find a free internet connection. If you have to pay to have the internet at your house, you're paying an internet service provider. Back in the day, they used to be separate companies. Now the internet service provider is also your TV and/or phone provider. Back in the day, you had to have a wired connection to access the internet. Now you can access the internet wirelessly. This is called Wi-Fi. Many businesses have free Wi-Fi for you to connect your device. The library offers free Wi-Fi and is currently offering free Wi-Fi if you're standing outside the library. Other words you may hear are modems and router. These are specific devices within a home or business. You need to have both the modem, which provides the internet, and the router, which provides the internet wirelessly. So that's how you access the internet. How you view and use the internet is an internet browser. And I will be showing you how to navigate an internet browser. I also want to mention a search engine. Google started out as a search engine, but now they created an internet browser, which is called Google Chrome. So the other internet browsers are Microsoft Edge, Mozilla Firefox, and Apple Safari. The first words are the companies, and the underlined word is the actual name of the internet browser. You don't have to say the whole thing when you're referring to an internet browser. I brought up Google Chrome first because, like I said, it started out as a search engine, and it still is a search engine, but they've become a large company and they've been offering more products. For more lessons on Google products, I offer Google Apps Part 1 and Part 2. You use a browser to visit websites, send email, play games, etc. Each browser has the same features, but the icons and the location of the icons might differ. I am just only going to be using Google Chrome for today's video tutorial. All internet browsers have an address bar. Back in the day, you had to know the specific address of a website and you had to type in correctly. Now, this address bar also acts as a search bar. So if you end up typing the website address incorrectly, it will give you a list of search results. So the library website is carsoncitylibrary.org. I typed in the website address correctly and it took me to the website. Say I typed it in wrong. It says the site can't be reached. I didn't even come close to a search result. So it didn't give me a list of results. But let's say I don't know the website address at all and I typed in just Carson City Library with spaces in between, like a search. Here it gives me a list of results. So if you type in here the address bar, and it doesn't take you to the website, that's because you typed in the website address incorrectly. Google Chrome shows you the list of results, and then you can also refine your search. If you click Maps, it's going to show you the location of the library. And I'm going to press this back button so I can go to the previous page. And if I want to go back to the maps, I could click on this, or I can go to the forward button. This forward button is grayed out right now because these are the only two web pages I've visited. Images, news, shopping, more, settings, tools. This is the settings to change your search. However, I'm not logged into an account, so it's not going to remember what I do. So this is more of an intermediate tool, but I just wanted to let you know for Google Chrome, all of these things. And then they have more information on the side here. So what we did was typed a website, went to the website, and then also looked at its search results. See, and I can go back. I can press the back button as much as I want. Oh, okay. So we'll stop here. So every internet browser, like I said, has an address bar. It has the back and forward button. This is the refresh button. When a page is not loading correctly, so if there's missing pictures, you can click on this button and it's going to reestablish connecting to that web page. Google Chrome, if you have a Google account or a Gmail account, you can log in to the entire browser, so it'll remember all of your favorite websites that you want to save. All your associated information is available if you sign in with your account. It's not necessary, it's up to you. People who want to use Google in its entirety, will make an account and have their favorite websites stored here underneath. So that's what we call a bookmarks bar. And now let's go to the settings of an internet browser. So I mentioned already that the three dots, in previous videos, I mentioned that the three dots mean more options. So click here and I can go to settings. Because I'm not signed in, it doesn't give me many things to change. So that's good to know. But however, let's talk about these functions here. I'm going to start with print. So if you wanted to print a web page, you can click here to print. If you're printing an email, you want to find the print button within the email somewhere. Because when you are printing this, you're printing what you see on the screen. If you want to print an email, it only prints that email. This is a very helpful tool, is Zoom. So if something's very hard to read, you can use Zoom out, or Zoom in, I'm sorry, to make it bigger, and then you can also Zoom out. If you download a file, it's gonna live here from the internet. So downloading a file is taking something from the internet. Best example is email. Say you received an email and it's pictures and you want to save the pictures on your computer. So that process is called downloading pictures. So all those downloads from the internet are gonna be here. So if you can't find it, you can go to this button and click on downloads. And files you download appear here. Okay. We're going to talk about new tabs and new windows now. See here, I have two tabs. Back in the day, you pretty much can only do stuff on the internet, like one thing at a time. Now you can work on many things at a time. So right now, this is the Google homepage, and then this is the Google settings, but I can open up a new tab. So I press the plus button to open up a new tab. And this time I'm going to go to the Carson City Library website. And then I can go on Amazon to look at books that I might want to buy if the library doesn't have it. I want to go to hotels.com to book my hotel reservation because I want to travel to, let's say, Las Vegas because I read about Las Vegas in a book. So I can do many internet-related things at the same time because of these tabs. What if I want to look at things side by side? So with this and this, I can't see things side by side. I'd have to click on them. So that's where new window comes in. So I'm going to go here to new window, and it opens up a new window for me. Now, how do I get it side by side? With Windows 10, this is called the minimize button. And I'm clicking and dragging this window to the left. Then I'm going to click and drag this window to the right. Click and drag this window this way. I'm going to click in this window to click and drag this way and rearrange and fix. So now I am on the library website, and let's go to Barnes & Noble on this window to compare what the library has and what Barnes & Noble has. Okay, isn't that really cool? So this video, you can watch anytime at your own pace, so you can pause and replay to see what I did. Another really cool thing about working with Google Chrome is that you can move tabs to other windows. So I'm gonna move Amazon. So I'm clicking and dragging the Amazon tab to the other window, and now I have Barnes & Noble and Amazon in this window. It's no longer in this window. Those are the basic functions of navigating an internet. Again, with other browsers, they're going to be in different places. I'm logged on to the library's practice account, carpractice@gmail.com. This is the account I used for all my computer lessons. You can also email me there if you have questions, but I hardly check it. I click here on these three dots and go to settings, and this is where it takes me. I want to explain sync. So syncing means connecting your account to a device, and everything that you do will show up on this device. But if you log on to another device with the same account, those devices are connected by the information that you share and all the things that you're doing. So for instance, if you have a photo on your account that you want to share or look at on another device, you can see the other photo. So it's a step above beyond emailing yourself the same photo. It's you storing your photo on the account, and then you can access your account on another device and look at it. This has paved the way a lot for businesses and companies in what we call collaboration. So it's really helpful to sync your things, especially if you have if you're using lots of things on your laptop and lots of things on your phone. You can sync certain things by adjusting your settings if you don't want to sync everything. If you share your computer with another person and you don't want to see what they're doing, you would go to your settings and then scroll down to clear browsing data. So that's where you clear your history, cookies, cache, and more. This might look intimidating because there's lots of things you can change within Google Chrome, but those are two of the important things. And the next thing I want to share with you is bookmarks. So I want to save the Carson City Library website as a bookmark. What this means is I don't want to have to type in the website address every time to get to this site. What I'm going to do is go to the site once and click the star. So I've already did that. So anytime you see the star filled in, that means you've already bookmarked it. The best way for me to click on my bookmark is actually going to the more options and going to bookmarks. And I'm going to do show bookmarks bar. I have all my books bookmarks on this bar. So instead of me having to type it in, I can just click here and it will take me there. So let me go to this old tab, click here, and it takes me to the website. Other websites you want to bookmark are your email, your banking, whatever websites, your favorite websites, sports, news. You can have all these bookmarks located here. Once this bar fills up, there's going to be an arrow where you can click on to look at more of your bookmarks. What's really helpful is you can even increase the amount of bookmarks you have here on your bookmarks bar. If you right click here, click on edit, and I'm just going to type in library, save, and it takes up less space on the bookmarks bar. If I rename every bookmark, so I can, instead of Greater Nevada Credit Union, I can just write GNCU. Instead of, you know, the University of Nevada Reno website, I can just write UNR. So you can have a lot of bookmarks here. That's pretty much the number one question we get for people who know how to use the internet, but they just want to learn more. But I'm hoping this helps you save time. And if you no longer use the website anymore, you can always unbookmark it by clicking on the star and remove. So it's no longer a bookmark and I don't have anything here. I know that was a short lesson on the internet. If you want to learn more, go to gcfglobal.org to learn more about internet basics. Another resource is this video. This is the Microsoft Edge video that I've already made for the Windows 10 for beginners. Feel free to check this video out if you just want to use Microsoft Edge. Thanks for watching. Stay strong, Carson City. Bye.